Hi everyone, how's it going? This is That Irish Dude. We are here with Final Fantasy 15. This is a game I've longed to play, and I'm very excited. I also have a special guest with me. This is Cody. Cody, say hi.
Okay, hi.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we're gonna be playing Final Fantasy. I'm super stoked. I love this game with a burning passion. They added a lot of new stuff to it. This will be a long Let's Play. Like, this one will be long, just because there's so much. And, yeah, pretty much. And then there's the DLC. So there's a lot of DLC. No, I don't need a tutorial. I'm just gonna, like, try to reacclimate. We're not gonna do the tutorial. Since a lot of people already know the game, too, I don't wanna make the Let's Play so long with a tutorial, but, like, two episodes difference? Not really that bad. Ugh, tomorrow's gonna be such a long day. Alright, yeah, Final Fantasy 15. In a time unknown, only a prophecy keeps hope alive in people's hearts. When darkness veils the world, the King of the Light shall come. Now four brave warriors begin their journey, prepared to fight. What awaits the four, however, they do not know. Yay! This is going to be a spoilered run-through, so, like, if you haven't played or seen much of it before, I'm sorry. But I've seen a lot of this. So. Oh, look, it's endgame already. Look, we're fighting Ifrit. Noctis Lucius Callum. This game looks really good, though. Like, I won't lie, this game has always looked good. What do you think, Cody? What do you think of Final Fantasy 15?
To be fair, I've never actually played it.
It's actually really good.
I'm noticing, like, a minimal to the gameplay, and that's all I'm driving.
It's very story-based, and it's long. Yeah. Let's go! And that's it for the beginning cutscene, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the game. Thanks for watching, and I'm just kidding. Before the fall. So, pretty much Insomnia before the fall. But the fall of what? Look how pretty it looks. Force field and all. I kind of wish that, like, this is what cities were like, where it was like there was
hour is come.
There's, like, force fields and things like that, and there's kings.
Set forth with my blessing, Prince Noctis.
Yes, Prince Noctis.
Your Majesty. Take your leave and go in the grace of the gods.
Okay, in the movie that they did with, like, pre-Final Fantasy 15, I think it was called Kingsglaive, they had Sean Bean playing as King Regis. I was like, that is the greatest voice ever. Then when I saw that, like, it wasn't Sean Bean in this game, I was really disappointed. It actually, like, broke my heart a little bit because Sean Bean has, like, the greatest king's voice ever.
So much for royal protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a
so pretty much
address.
Ned Stark would be your father.
Your Highness.
Dratos. King Regis. What happened to your leg, buddy?
What now?
He's like a rebellious child. It's so annoying.
I fear I have left too much unsaid.
It's okay.
You
no,
place
you don't.
A great burden on those who would bear with you.
Yes, I know.
You're one to talk. I ask not that you guide my wayward son.
It's like Regis knows that, like, the end is coming.
Indeed, your grace.
We'll see the prince to Altissia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said.
Altissia.
But Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing. Do mind your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Oh. It's like a father saying goodbye to his son for the last time.
Try to mind yours.
Like, if you know the story, like, this scene breaks your heart a little bit.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
You think I would?
I need only know that you are ready to leave home.
This is so heartbreaking.
I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road.
See, it's like he's the last time he sees him. Go.
The line of Lucis goes with you.
Oh, my heart.
So pretty much you're saying it's like me saying goodbye to you right now.
My son.
Yeah, funny. No. It's like a father's... It's a father saying goodbye to his son for like the last time. It's heartbreaking. Because you see what happens, like... You'll see, like, in the playthrough, you'll probably see in a couple episodes, like, what's gonna happen. It's heartbreaking. Like, it hurts. Like, you'll see it, and you'll be like, wow, like, that's what happens. You know? It's like, that's it. Like, he's dead. It's weird. It's weird. Like, it's gonna hurt. A Magitek exosuit. Oh.
Yeah, oh, so, I can't relate.
I know you can't. It's okay. How could you relate to what Noctis is? He's a prince. He just said goodbye to his father for the last time, and then, like, it's heartbreaking. His father is like, walking on one leg, is responsible for a kingdom. His son, his only son, is, like, doesn't give a shit. Like, could you imagine, like, if you were in that position as the father? Like, your son clearly does not care. He's rebellious and does not care, but then it's like, oh, you know, just, I'm out, like, I'm ready to go, like, yeah, don't worry about me, and it's like, oh, well, this kingdom's about to, like, burn down, but no big deal. Altissia, capital of Accorda, where he will familiarize with the Union States through his, oh, okay. Great. I don't know, it's just heartbreaking. But I do love this scene, just because it's so, like, adventure-y. Like, I do like the adventure aspect where it's like, yeah, you're in the car and you're doing all these things and it's fun. It is fun. Like, there is like a journey to it, you know?
I think we can forget about hitching our way there.
Yeah.
Thought forget people it. Were friendly outside the city.
No, people are so not friendly.
Kindness of strangers. You're just gonna have to push her all the way.
Yeah.
I've already pushed myself. To the brink of
when you learn about Prompto's history.
Get up. Come on, car isn't gonna move itself.
Why is it Ignis Jeez. Pushing and like Prompto is like?
I thought the car was supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
Sorry, guys, this is the long part. Wow. Oh.
Oh my god, I thought you said something different.
What did you think I said?
That was the long part.
Oh, no. Why would you think I'd say that? Vroom, vroom. Look, guys, we're changing lanes. Peep.
Unbelievable.
Not exactly a fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
Look, these things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some...
This is literally like the scene where you're supposed to see like half the stuff in the game.
Just this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice it. Yeah. Just let go.
Prompto, don't even think about it.
Yeah, Prompto.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nuh-uh, we just switched back there.
And it's my turn, Noct.
His turn.
My hands are killing me.
You rather I kill
Well, technically, Noctis is the prince, so can he just, like, sit in the car?
Only a busy signal.
Hold the phone. Is it just me? Was it supposed to be way closer?
I assure you, the map is correct.
The map said Hammerhead was right there.
Literally, next door.
Looks that way, on a map of the world.
This is the beginning, everyone. I hope you enjoy this. Just casually, just pushing along.
The world's a big old place,
filled with wonders.
Tell that to my legs.
You guys even pushing?
Yes, we're pushing.
Hard as I can.
Final Fantasy 15. I love this game. Yep, there's Hammerhead. And there goes the music. Lunafreya Nox Fleure. Prince Noctis's betrothed. Lady Lunafreya met her new fiancé as a young girl when he visited her home in Tenebrae. Unable to pronounce her name in full, the boy prince once inadvertently called her Luna. And the abbreviation stuck. Luna! There's Hammerhead. I would have loved to have lived here. This would have been cool.
the girl waiting. Now, which one's the prince? Aha! Hello, your highness. Congrats on your wedding.
Not hitch just yet.
He's single.
To be here in Hammerhead.
He is single Pringle. I'm just kidding. He's engaged.
Apologies for Papa.
Well, that makes you.
Cindy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
Sid.
Roll her in while I'm still young.
Oh, Sid.
Didn't
how you're loved.
Tell you?
Not the actual same Sid, but.
She's a custom classic, not some beat up old clunker.
Oh, Sid.
Prince Noctis.
Oh, Sid.
Yeah.
Prince. Like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
Damn.
You got a long way to go, son. And that slackjaw's getting you nowhere fast.
Wow. Get roasted. Damn, like, could you imagine, like, if you were a prince and, like, everyone's telling you, like, yeah, you ain't nothing.
Y'all get her in and run along.
Just, like, run, ruin your dignity. So, these recordings also I'm going to do in 30-minute spans. We'll do 30 minutes
Let's
each. And we'll go from there.
Right this way.
Since this is going to be a super long run-through, I want the episodes to be a little bit longer. And we'll see where we go from there.
Never
we'll just see.
Never any good at it either.
Oh, no. Just you jerk. Now, unless we're in the middle of a fight and we hit the 30-minute mark, then we'll go a little longer. If not, then... Cindy. How you doing, sweet cheeks?
Y'all ain't never been out this way before, have you?
Oh, Sydney.
Go on, have a look around. This
Cindy
sure
is a cutie. World map. Anything else, Cindy?
Well, might as well make good use of the extra time.
Now, let's see what we got. Gear. It's great. Noctis. Engine blade. Look! Ragnarok! Look what we got in the beginning! Oh yeah, I forgot, we have Maz immune, like, we're just gonna trick Noctis out, like, early. I guess that's all we can do. Accessories... that enables Noctis to sprint and hang without expending stamina. So unlimited stamina, basically. That's cool. That renders the entire party impervious to magical friendly fire. Don't really care. That kind of kills the realistic feel. That stops experience points from being tallied, preventing the party. Accelerates the tech bar replenishment roll. The army gear freezes the tech bar. Scroll sheet. Okay, alright, cool. Attire. No jacket. Just kidding. What is this? Wow, we look very dangerous. Festival ensemble. Oh! That's so cool. Oh, they actually have, like, effects. That's really funny. Uses Magitek energy to generate a barrier that wards the wearer from harm. No, we're gonna go with just the no jacket. Gladius. What if I gave you another sword? Would you like that? Alright, I'll give you the Key of Prosperity because I'm feeling generous. Ignis. I really have to... Wow. It's so weird playing on, like, a profile like this where you have, like, nothing. Alright, we're just gonna go with what we got here.
Whoa! They got Ebony out here. Oh, Ignis is gonna flip.
Yeah?
What's a gil? I got a feeling our money's no good here, Noct.
Bet you Ignis came prepared, though. Let's ask him.
Ignis!
Room and board.
Ignis!
A moment, Noct. We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs. I suggest we confer with Cindy.
Okay.
Broken down and flat broke.
Adding insult to
injury. Isn't Noctis a prince?
Old man's in for both. You're charging us that much.
Yeah, let's pay him a visit.
She ain't gonna be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
We're greedy.
Bit steep for a simple tune-up, don't you think?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson. Told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus around here. I'd be happy to pay y'all for your services if
yeah.
you're up to the challenge.
Yeah. Yeah.
So much for finding an easy way out. Thanks a lot, Papa.
Yeah. Timed quests.
But don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds.
Oh, no.
This ought to be enough for a place to stay. Just between us, though. Don't tell Papa.
Papa! I won't tell him.
Better make tracks.
Ignis, we're going.
On my way.
Looks like we got our first target. Ready, Noct?
Got all those arms at your disposal? Use them.
Outstanding, Noct.
Yep.
Bam.
Excellent work. Yes. On we go.
I'm so special. What's here, though?
What happened here?
A telegraph pole's been split in two. And not just this one, either.
The hell do you think did this?
Hard to say. Natural disaster, perhaps?
You sure? A hammerhead doesn't have a scratch on it.
Maybe a huge monster came and knocked him down.
It better not be the varmint Cindy was talking about.
Ooh. I love peaceful, friendly music. It makes me calm and happy. And I know we're using DLC, like, in the beginning, and it kind of, like, defeats the purpose of building, but you know what? This game gets hard, and I don't care. I'd rather be OP. Early. Balances out later. I'm trying to. Come on.
Don't wear yourself out like that. Take cover and rest up.
Yes, everyone dance around the scorpion.
Don't.
Alright, I'm killing it.
We needn't waste more time.
Yeah.
Alright. We'll be done in no time.
Let's get on with it.
Ah, weak knock.
So, where are we headed anyway?
Nowhere until the repairs are done. Then we head for Golden Key.
And after that, we hop a boat, and before you know it, lover boy's hitched.
Wait for car repairs, then wedding bells in the air. Got it.
Almost there. Give it your all.
Bam.
Let's be done with this riffraff.
Don't hurt my friend.
Nice.
We're done. Yay! We're done. We're done.
Who could this be?
Oh, we got a phone call.
Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
That's great, because I got one more hunt for y'all. Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off, and we ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out his...
I wonder where... Right there.
Shack. Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
Cindy say?
Needs us to find some Dave guy.
Missing?
Not missing. Said he's holed up in that shack.
Watch, we're gonna be fighting in here. Ready? Hello?
What's this?
Dave? Mutant... Dullhorn sighting, codename Bloodhorn. Characterist Red Tusk, extremely violent. Outstanding bounty on Saber Tusks in the area.
Knocked!
Uh-oh.
You okay?
We are now.
Spoke too soon.
I'll say I'm okay.
What can I say?
Knocked! What's the idea?
Apologies.
Ran over here as fast as I could.
Why? Well, you never asked her to.
Don't be like that!
Get lost!
There.
Hey, what about the shack over there?
No, there's so many shacks. Stop this madness. I thought I heard something. Oh, yeah.
Not yet. Got a plan.
What? No! I had it!
Huh. What are we looking at?
This creature is known as a saber tusk. It skewers prey with its tusks, extracting game from the safety and comfort of burrows.
That's a bit heartless.
Yeah, don't think we'll be friends.
Can I warp? They're moving too much. Stop moving. Ow.
Brilliant. No big deal.
None the worse for wear.
Hey,
we done? There? Hello, Dave.
Well, and look who's in here. The man of the hour. Dave, right? Been looking for you.
Didn't mean to cause y'all any trouble. I've been stuck here on account of my sprained ankle.
Yeah, something funny about them varmints. I gave them hell, but couldn't finish the job. Still one mean mutt about. Well, y'all don't look much like hunters, but what do you say? Put that puppy to rest for me?
Ask my friends.
Oh, sounds too dangerous to be let alone. Tell us where to go.
Well, y'all got guts, that's for sure. Let me tell you where I last saw him.
So we're doing this for free?
The people are at risk, Noct. You have a royal duty to ensure their safety.
Fuck off. Alright, Ignis. Cool. Whatever. Making me do things. Oh, this is such a far run, too. I'm so sorry. What? What?
It'd be wise to rest up before we set out.
Sure.
In that case, let's find a spot to make camp.
The hunters are really out in full force around here, huh?
So they're the new Crown's Guard or something?
Similar, though technically a civilian outfit.
They've definitely seen a lot more action than we have.
Is it cool that we rock Crown's Guard outfits?
Be worse not to. They made them especially for us.
Even got a sweet insignia on them.
In the Crown's Guard, your attire identifies you. So wear it with pride.
Yeah, wear it with pride. And up.
You want to make camp?
Let's call it a day.
All right. I'm gonna pitch the tent.
All right. So now we are making camp. Where do you have the space for all this stuff? Where do you have the space for all this stuff? This doesn't make sense. It literally defies every sense of logic. Where do you get a big tent, a grill, food, which you thought y'all were broke, and four chairs? I don't know. Flame roasted toast. Y'all only are getting toast. No, we'll have pizza. I want pizza. Yes, Ignis, you're gonna make me pizza. Pizza. Actually looks pretty good. Sprinting without expending stamina and... Da 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 da. Wow, Ignis is already a level 4. Okay.
Nailed it. Why can't I warp too? So unfair.
Because it's a king's power, warping. Come on. Actually, it's... What is it called? I don't know. Tutorials offer wealth, blah, blah, blah.
Like a father to her.
Ever since they got back, Sid's been the only one looking after her.
Rather more than a middling mechanic can handle.
So we'll go with that for the first episode. We got through a good amount. Obviously took a little while. First episode, usually Let's Plays, usually take longer, so...
Thank you guys for the fun.
See you in the next one.